In this video, you will learn how to create a simple overpainting using Krita. This overpainting we'll use as our first concept art or first sketch for our 3D scene. And this is very useful if you not know how your final scene should look like. The great thing about such an overpainting is that one can do it very fast. You don't really need to be good at drawing, and you also don't need to know how to use colors. So it's a perfect thing for everyone. For this overpainting, we'll use a photo you can see here. And with this method, we will create this image here. You can see I've added a robot and two boys in the foreground. And on the ground, you can see I have added some concrete blocks from another photo. And for the whole image, I just needed less than 30 minutes. Sure, you can see all the lines and drawings I have added there, but that's not the point of such an overpainting. It doesn't should look nice, it just should give me an idea how my final scene could look like. For our 3D scene, for example, we didn't know how exactly this all could look like. So we took some photos, did some different overpaintings, and then from all those overpaintings, we used the best things and put it together to one final scene we created then in 3D. So in the end, we didn't have any perfect concept art that exactly fits to our 3D scene, but we had some ideas we get from those overpaintings for our final scene. Here you can see another example that I have created a while ago. This photo from this old rusty car is from cgtextures.com. And after I did my overpainting, you can see I got this post-apocalyptical hovercraft car. And the great thing is I just needed to add my ideas on top of the car. So I didn't need to know how exactly such a car is built up or how the perspective is and so on. I just got everything from the image and I just added what I want. Alright, let's open Krita. I'm using Krita 2.9.6 from krita.org. Just a side note, certainly you can use any painting software you like for such an overpainting. We're using Krita here because it's free, it's open source, and after testing different painting tools, personally I like Krita the most. For painting, I won't use the mouse, I'll use a graphics tablet. And with this, painting is really fun because you really have a pen in your hand and also you have pressure sensitivity. That means the harder I press on my graphics tablet with the tip of the pen, my brushes get thicker or thinner, or the opacity of my brushes get stronger or weaker. Personally, I think the best graphic tablets you can buy from the company Wacom. So if you don't have a graphics tablet, take a look at the website wacom.com. There you find all the infos about the products this company is offering. Alright, let's start with the overpainting. For this, I open these two images here. And then you can see I can switch them using these tabs up here. On this image here, we'll create the overpainting. And from the other image, I really like these concrete blocks. And these blocks I'll cut out and copy paste it to the other image. So for this, I use a polygon selection tool and select the two concrete blocks. Then I press Ctrl C to copy the selection. Then I switch to our main image and I press Ctrl V to paste the concrete blocks. So now I don't like the position of the blocks, so I use my move tool and move it in a way that the gap of these two blocks are aligned directly on this trail here. And then I use the scale tool to scale it to a size I like. So the background and the concrete blocks I lock by clicking on these padlock symbols so that we don't accidentally paint on these images. To make the painting process a little bit more convenient, we don't like to click inside our menus. So we have this very useful right click menu. And here you can choose between some very useful preset brushes. And also you can adjust the color of your brush. And down here you'll find even more presets of brushes. And now I start my overpainting simply picking one color from the image by pressing Ctrl and left click in the image. So first of all I pick a really dark color and start with very simple lines to draw such a old robot here. Then I pick another color, like a yellowish or reddish color, make it a little bit stronger using the color adjustment tool here, and paint this color on top of my robot. To shade this robot, I simply make the same color a little bit darker and paint these areas where less light comes on top of the robot. And for the highlights, I use a bit brighter version of the same color and put it on top of the robot again. And then with thinner lines, I just add small details. And here we really don't need to care about if we paint over some trees in the foreground. We can fix this later on. Sometimes I use E for the eraser and just erase some lines here and there. And then I pick a green color and add some green stuff like grass or little trees or something like that also on top of the robot. Then if I'm happy with the robot so far, I add another layer using the plus symbol and add it below the robot layer. And then I paint with a dark brownish color below the robot so that we get some water reflections and shadows. And using a mix brush, I simply mix those colors a bit into each other. Then I add some small thin lines on top of the water so the reflection looks a little bit more like a water reflection. And in the end, I use my eraser and delete all these parts from the robot and the reflections that are on top of the trees in the foreground. To finalize the robot, I just add very small thin lines as highlights. And voila, done with the robot. Now I zoom out a bit and you can see the concrete blocks didn't really fit to the ground below. And because of that, I simply pick some colors from the ground and the concrete and try to blend the blocks into our scene a little bit better. And here you can see here are some leaves from a tree on top of the block. And I simply pick some colors from the concrete and paint it over. And so we can simply retouch those leaves. Then I add this broken edge on the block here on the side. And you really don't need to care that all this stuff looks totally perfect. So to finalize the image, I add two persons. For that, I just pick a very dark color and try to line out these characters a bit. The person in the background points on the robot he just discovered, and the person in the foreground like, "Oh wow, I can't believe this great looking robot thing back there. Never saw something like that." You know, then I pick some colors and paint the skin colors and the claws, but keep it very simple so I don't go much into detail. So I don't draw faces or anything like that. It just should give me an idea how the persons can interact with the scene. Then another idea came to my mind to add such a tower back here and also this pillar steel stuff here. So the whole image looks a little bit more interesting. So after I'm done with the overpainting, I use the crop tool to crop the image so just the important part is visible in the end. And if I like the selection, I simply press enter. So now to blend the image and the painting a little bit better together, I will add some color adjustment and some filter. For example, I could click on filters up here and add some color filters, but you can see it only adjusted the selected layer. So I want the filter to be applied on all our layers. So I click down here on this plus button and I can add a filter layer. So it's a layer that will be placed on top of all the other layers. So all the other layers which are lying below will be adjusted through the filter. So here I use the color adjustment filter. And with this I can adjust the brightness and also the red, green and blue channel. And with this I can simply add some contrast and put a little bit more red into my scene so it looks a little bit nicer. So then I press OK and then I add another filter layer and here we add the oil paint filter. Then I put the smooth value down to 10 so the oil paint lines will get a little bit thinner. And through this filter the whole image looks more painted so you can't recognize the original photo too much anymore. So the painted layers fits a little bit better to the photo background. Yeah, and now we are done with our overpainting. As I said, this image just took me less than 30 minutes. So, and if you're working on such a 3D project, you don't just need to do one overpainting. Just try out different overpaintings. You can add different stuff. Maybe you add bicycles or you try out different backgrounds. Or you do different overpaintings with the same background. Maybe you place a robot on a completely different position in the image. Also, you can place persons on a different place, or you add completely different things to your scene. Also, very helpful could be to cut out elements from other images and paste it into your overpainting image. For example, you can cut out some cars from another image, paste it into this image, and then paint over those cars that they are fitting a little bit more to the background. So you see, there are many possibilities to really simply create a nice concept art for your 3D scene.